I'm here for the Childhood Cancer Awareness Day your Tanya had, and to, I guess, for everybody to get to know each other and talk about our kids and to remember my son, Philip. He was diagnosed in 2012 with medulloblastoma. It's a brain cancer. He was 8 years old when he was diagnosed. He passed away February 14th, 2015. And before things got bad, he was really active, fine. You wouldn't know he was sick. And then he just started having seizures, and they couldn't stop the seizures, so we had to bring him home on hospice. There's only four of the chemo drugs specifically made for children. And I think there are 30 types, but they're made for adults that kids have to take. They're made for adults, but the kid's body just, you know, they really can't. So even if kids get over their cancer, the chemo treatments make them, you know, have, I know with Philip, if he would have lived, he would have been deaf because of the chemo he took. And a lot of the chemo treatments can cause other types of cancers. So that's, you know, not only do you have to worry about the cancer, you have to worry about what the chemo does to them also.
Ava was 5 years old, and she was the most vibrant child. I've had four children, and Ava was the most feisty, most amazing, most lovely child I've ever had. And she was one of a kind. You know, there are no words to fully describe Ava. You just had to know her. She was a force to be reckoned with. And when she was diagnosed with brain cancer, it was a total surprise, a total shock. It was the last thing I expected for her to have, but she still fought it her way. She was gonna do everything her way up until the end, and she absolutely did. There's no other words for it. DIPG is a form, it's a brain tumor, but it is in the pons of the brain stem. It's inoperable, and it is fatal upon diagnosis. There is a less than 1% survival rate. And treatments for DIPG are over 35 years old with no advancements in the treatments within those 35 years. There's the basic radiation you can do, chemo, and hope and pray for the best, honestly. You're living on borrowed time when you get that diagnosis. The first sign that something was wrong with Ava was her eyes. Her eyes started turning inward, and it would never move back. And I knew something was wrong, and we went to an eye doctor, and he referred us to a large hospital. But by that time, her left side of her body, she was dragging it. She couldn't use her left arm, and it was staying clenched up like this. Just watch your child. Watch for any physical differences. Cancer will show itself, and sometimes it takes a long, it took us 2 months before we found out what it was. It can take a while, but don't give up. You know, no matter what the doctors tell you, if you follow up, push on, and find out what's wrong with your baby, because you don't know what you're facing. And it could be that it could be curable, and you could keep your child for the rest of your life. Or you could find out that you just have a little bit of time left. It's the truth.
Yeah, and just look up the symptoms. Always go with your gut. If you feel like something ain't right, no matter how many times you're told that, you know, they don't know or it's nothing, to just keep it up and to look up these. I mean, look up the symptoms online and really dig into it yourself, because, you know, that's what happened with Philip. I wish I would have knew that early morning vomiting was one of the symptoms, but I thought he was just trying to get out of going to school because he'd just be sick one time of the morning a couple of times of the week, and I didn't know that that was one of the symptoms until it was, you know, and it can buy a lot of time, and time's precious, you know, for treatment with these kids.
4% of all national cancer funding goes to children, just 4%. And with the kind of cancer Ava had, they deemed it rare, so how little of that 4% went to any kind of research for her? They deserve so much more. They deserve to not have to worry if they're gonna live or die. And no parent should have to make plans for their child's funeral. We need more. I was very blessed to be her mother. And I'm very honored God gave me that baby for 6 years. He had a plan that I didn't understand and I still don't understand, but I know where my daughter is. And I thank God every day that He gave me that for 6 years, even in the bad. I understand now what people say when I would have gave my life for hers, and I still would today. So my prayers are for everybody going through this. And I'm very sorry, and I pray that there is a cure one day, and this is behind us, and nobody ever has to go through this. Eventually one day, I hope that's how it will be.